Welcome to the Pearl Pirates Football Coaches Show here at Mugshots Grill and Bar. Of course, sitting here with me again, Patrick Schuler. Coach Patrick Schuler for the Pearl Pirates. Talk to me, coming off a great win against Ridgeland Titans, 22-12. Let's get into it.
Big win, right?
Yeah.
Big win. Anytime you get a win, it's a big win right now. So I'm very pleased with the team's effort and execution. Now, it wasn't perfect by no means, but I thought we got after them pretty well. And I was able to get some success offense early. Get them out of what they wanted to do on offense. And like I said, at the end of the day, we came out with a win and proud for it.
Absolutely. And, of course, I know the morale, not only within the coaches but the players as well, has been lifted. You know, there was a good, hard win against Ridgeland. We went out there fighting, still using that wing tee offense. Let's talk a little bit about that.
Just got after them pretty well. You know, it got better, right? You know, after another week doing something stuff like that, we got better with it. I thought Peyton had a really good game. Put the ball on the ground too many times. We got to eliminate those problems. Able to throw a few passes and get them off and get them completed at Kenji. And each week we're going to keep trying to add to it, and make it a little more explosive. So just got to keep getting better.
Right, you know? Right. And what was practice like coming off of that win today?
A little sluggish today. Okay. You know, Monday's a little slow for us. We watch a lot of film and get a good workout in. Then you got to be in and out so quick for the seventh grade's playing tonight, or playing right now, actually. So you got to be able to attack it with a little better mindset. And we still haven't figured it out yet as a team. But so maybe tomorrow and Wednesday have a really good day and feel good about Friday.
Absolutely. And what are we implementing this week to get ready for Germantown? I'm sure a lot of families want to know just what are some of those strategies that we're going to be putting together.
Just keep getting better at what we do. You know, not a whole lot of change going on. You know, you got to keep polishing things we do right, fixing things we do wrong. So on both sides, on all three phases. You know, well, we didn't set the ball very well last Friday on the special teams, and it cost us a couple PATs and a blocked punt. You know, there's a lot of pressure on Owen. He has to get better there, and he knows it. And he accepted that role, and he's going to get better there. But you know, all three phases play such a huge part of the game.
Right.
So. But I thought offensively our snaps were great. You know, that's where it all starts at. Peyton handled the offense really well. He ran the football well. JT ran the football really well.
Right.
And then the line got after him.
Right.
You know, were we perfect? No. We had some run-throughs. Of course we did. But I thought the effort and I thought the execution was 100% better than it was the week before.
Right.
So if we can keep improving at that rate, you know, by the time we get to division play, we should be in a pretty good spot.
And I know Peyton stepping into that role for this wing tee offense, really stepping up to be a leader during this time. Of course, Story being injured, still trying to work out a couple of things for him, also trying to make sure he's recovering well
as
we get closer into district play. Talk a little bit about Peyton and how he stepped up to this role.
You know, a lot though on a sophomore, especially who was actually a running back coming into it. He played quarterback last year, the ninth grader, but he ain't played quarterback since, right? So he came in and just – you know, never tried to bucket, just rode with it and got better and get better and better. He gets better every day.
Yeah.
You know, is he the quarterback of the future? Probably not. Hope not. Hope we get Jack back next year and we got a good young one coming up, but he's the quarterback now. And so we're going to play that hand we're dealt and we're going to get better.
Absolutely. And as we talk about Story, of course, not being able to play that role, how has his morale been? Of course, being the leader on the sideline, how have the players been able to interact well with that?
Yeah, he's been really good. He's been behind Peyton the whole time. Giving advice here and there, you know, and so he's been really good there, really has. And he had to come in Friday night, throw a few balls around. And again, we didn't want him to, but kind of had to, right?
Absolutely.
So hope he can get back healthy. And so we're trying not to rush it too fast.
Absolutely.
Because we need him for division play, for the ones that really matter. But, you know, he's getting better every day. He rehabs good every day. He ices, you know, he's doing all he can to be ready to play. So, you know, but when they get him back, hopefully we should be better up front, and the running back should be as good as they've always been. So, you know, again, right now it's Peyton and run the offense, and we're going to rally behind him and try to keep scoring points.
Absolutely. Well, let's segue right now. Let's get into what we've been talking about as far as the Ridgeland Pirates being at Ridgeland. Of course, you have a couple plays here, Coach. Let's talk and walk through some of those.
Yeah.
And what are you seeing here so far? I mean, Peyton really just doing work, really
big,
doing
big
what he
strong
needs to
run
do.
By JT there. The O-line gets up and blocks. We got a hat on a hat there. You know, we can't run by people there. You know, we got a lineman running by everybody. If he picks one of those guys up, we're good. Here another one of strong runs by Peyton by JT. You know, kicked his shoe off, kept running, right?
Yeah, strong runner.
Strong
Jayden
run
is man.
Jayden runs strong. You know, we moved him from safety to running back, and it's been a been a tremendous move by him. I mean, he's accepted that role and has become our featured back, per se. So that's a big-time play for us. Gets on board, tie the ball game up. Here's a big, strong run by Peyton. That's a big physical run. He's tough to tackle. He's a big bowling ball of fun. So, you know, look, lines up there blocking. Well, kind of again. But good tough run. He's hard to handle, really is. And defensively, you know, just what they do offensively is tough, and you got to be really assignment labeled football. And I thought we was really good all night long of staying in our gaps, staying in our assignments. You know, we forced 3 or 4 turnovers.
Right.
You know, you can do stuff like that, you're gonna be really good. Big play here, strung out, and we let him slip in the end zone. So you just can't. All that, we was really good everywhere, but one person, right? And that one person got exposed. Here's a big-time run by Peyton, just to, you know, showing off. You know, he may not be the fastest guy out there, but he is hard to block. He's hard to tackle, right? You know,
yeah, he is.
He's
coach.
Shifty and nifty. You know, figures out where to score. You know, it's just, that's a tough run.
Yeah.
You know, and people get tired of tackling a guy that weighs 200 pounds.
Right.
So.
Yeah, and of course, we've been noticing that as well, too. When he really gets open field, he can really – I mean, you see him really turn it
on. His vision is really, really good. I mean, he sees it, the cutbacks, and he's just, you know, just – again, he's taking his role and running with it.
Yeah.
So, you know.
And what is the – as far as the offense been really implementing to really allow that to showcase?
Well, you know, misdirection, stuff like that. And anytime the quarterback run the football – it puts the defense in a bind.
Yeah.
Because now you got 2 or 3 guys running the football and you can't key on one of them. So that's what we're doing with him right now. And he's, I think, doing it pretty well.
Absolutely.
You know, pulled a few balls Friday night on read plays and went out the back door on it. And then when you do that, the defense got to slow up a little bit. They can't just go flying in on the running back. So, but he definitely gives you problems.
Right.
Anytime you got a dual threat quarterback, it puts you in a big bind. So
that's right. And of course, as we get closer to Germantown, are we still looking to implement the wing T offense? Are we looking to maybe shift anything out?
We're going to stay where we're at, probably,
until
we can decide to get out of it.
So. Absolutely. Any other remarks as far as for the families? I always like to, you know, talk about the families and friends that really came out. Pearl, we've always talked about this, showcases, and they come out to the games.
Good crowd Friday night. You know, and the kids needed that, right? I mean, it's been a pretty rough 2 weeks in a row for us, and been on the road 3 straight weeks now, so... You know, you look up in the stands and they're full, and at times you could hear them. You know, a lot of times you can hear them on the sidelines, you're involved in the game, but at times you hear the crowd get into it. So, you know, and the kids got to hear that. They got to feel that support, and they got to feel the excitement in the air a little bit. So, you know, it's always great when you have a good band playing, good cheerleaders cheering, dancers dancing,
right.
Fans cheering. That's what Friday Night Football is all about.
Absolutely.
So.
Well, you've heard it best and first right here from Coach Patrick Schooler with the Pearl Pirates. Stay tuned here on the Pearl Pirate Football Coaches Show. We'll have more coming up for you here at the Mugshots Grill and Bar.
When Pirates need a feast, they sail to Mugshots Grill and Bar. Voted best burger in Mississippi for 13 years in a row, Mugshots proudly serves fresh, never frozen certified Angus beef. X marks a spot at 2 locations on the map, in Pearl and Riverwind Drive in the movie theater parking lot, and in Flowood on the corner of Airport Road and Lakeland Drive. You can dine in, take out, or order online and pick up curbside. Check out mugshotsgrillandbar.com.
Welcome to Sky Family Dental, where our mission is to provide the finest care available. Here at Sky Family Dental, we strive to help patients live healthier lives. We provide a caring, nurturing environment where your comfort and health is of primary importance. Our staff is dedicated to providing you with a pleasant visit and results that you're proud to show off. We provide all services, including dental exams, child dentistry, dental fillings or implants, tooth extractions, and more. See us at Sky Family Dental, and a bright, healthy smile can be yours.
When something works this well,
paying bills,
this site is so comprehensive, I do all my banking online. More time for coffee.
You want to get others excited about it too.
Yes, honey. They're very conscientious, and they're about helping us map out a plan for our future.
It's nice to know we make a difference.
It was so easy. They had lots of creative ways to help me afford the loan for the cutest car I've wanted.
And
for
that a
so
great
long.
Bank is a really important thing to have. Comprehensive, conscientious, creative, community bank like no other bank you know.
What can I get for you?
Can I have one scoop of strawberry, please?
That'll be $2. Here you are.
What are you? You don't have cones.
Of course. That'll be an extra $2.
A napkin?
That'll be an extra $1.
Spoons come standard.
You wouldn't put up with this at the ice cream truck. Don't put up with it when you buy a car.
So come to Rogers Dab Chevrolet.
It's easier here.
We're back here on the Pearl Pirate Football Coaches Show at Mugshots Grill and Bar, where I have beside me Kenji McNair, wide receiver, and Colston Bennett, the field goal kicker and the punter as well, too. Let's get into it. We're coming off a great win against Ridgeland Titans, 22-12. The morale has been lifted as we get closer into practice this week, but of course, Germantown coming up on Friday. Talk to me and talk to the fans watching. Kenji, you want to start it off?
Colston, Kenji.
All right. Yeah, we're excited for it. We think we're ready for them. I think we're going to beat them.
Good.
Yeah, good. First district game. I feel like if we have a good week of practice, then we can beat them.
Good, good. And I always like to ask this question, of course, between the players, how has that community been? I know y'all have a great connection. Talk a little bit about that as we get closer to Germantown.
It's really hard to explain. Just know the connection that all of us have. We've all been playing together since we were in seventh grade.
Yeah.
No one has moved. We had the same team for forever, so it's like our connection is good. We just got to communicate more.
Yeah. Coach, do you want to add
Yes,
to
sir.
That?
Yeah, I really feel like we're a lot like a family. You know, we've been through a lot together. You know, our main group, we've all essentially been the same team since seventh grade.
Yeah. Good, good. And, you know, as you get closer to this big game for y'all at Germantown, what are some of the things that y'all two have noticed as far as watching film, but you've seen improvement on?
Open field tackles, for sure. And the O-line has gotten a lot better. They know how to pass it more, and they're more aggressive now.
Yeah.
Just getting better every day, so.
Good, good.
I think our special teams as a whole has gotten better, whether it's, you know, punt coverage, kickoff coverage, field goal blocking. I think we've gotten a lot better.
And I was talking to Coach Morgino. He said you were actually having to get back on the things of punting. And so talk about, I mean, you know, you're almost having to work two sides of the field now. Talk a little bit about that.
Yes, sir. It's a little bit different because I didn't punt last year. So it's just a lot of doing drops and, you know, short stuff, contact drills with the ball and things like that.
Good, good. And, you know, another leave off as well, as y'all continue to progress, you get closer, right? What do y'all want to see happen with this team this year?
I want to see us go far into the playoffs, possibly win the championship. That's the goal I want.
Yeah.
Yep. I want to win a state championship.
What does that mean when you think of the state championship? Of course, we think back to when we did win it for the Pearl Pirates. When you think about that for the future and how possible that is with this team, what are some of the thoughts that come to mind?
The thought that I have that come to mind is that we can do it if everybody just locks in and have the same mentality. Everybody just want to do the same thing. If everybody is on the same page, then I feel like we're a good team.
Yeah.
Yep, I feel the same way.
Yeah. Good, good. You know, another question I do have in mind that just came up. What's the next thing for y'all? What's the next big thing for Pearl Pirates? You know, of course, we got the championship. We want to win that this year. When we think about how well y'all have been looking over film, what would be the next goal you want to see it hit? Of course, state champions is going to be the big thing, but what else would you want to add to that?
To beat Brandon.
Really? Okay. Okay, let's talk about that a little bit. That'll be coming up.
Get them home playoff game.
Yeah.
So that means we will have to win all of our district games. I really want a home playoff game, so yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. When we talk about Brandon, that's a big rivalry for us.
Yeah.
And, of course, I know something that y'all have grown up, especially living here in Pearl, y'all have seen, and now you're getting to have that opportunity to do it again this year. Any
yes,
remarks
sir.
To that?
I think we can do it.
Yep. I think we got them this year.
Okay, good, good. We heard it here first, Kenji McNair, Colston Bennett, Brandon Bulldogs right around the corner from us as far as playing them. And so you've heard it from them both first. We're going to be able to beat them. And I know as a Pearl Pirate family, we're looking forward to that win as well, too. Stay here with the Pearl Pirate Football Coaches Show on Mugshots Grill and Bar. We'll have more coming up.
When Pirates need a feast, they sail to Mugshots Grill and Bar. Voted best burger in Mississippi for 13 years in a row, Mugshots proudly serves fresh, never frozen certified Angus beef. X marks a spot at two locations on the map, in Pearl and Riverwind Drive in the movie theater parking lot, and in Flowood on the corner of Airport Road and Lakeland Drive. You can dine in, take out, or order online and pick up curbside. Check out mugshotsgrillandbar.com.
At Bob Boyd Honda, we pride ourselves in getting our customers the best deals around.
Usually, that means when we're selling cars, but right now...
Bob Boyd is in the market to buy!
We're offering top dollar for pre on autos, trucks, and SUVs.
Come by, talk to our dedicated team, and discover what a great time it is for Bob Boyd to buy back your used vehicle. Any make, any model.
Whether you're selling or buying, at Bob Boyd Honda, you get a deal.
Shop, stay, dine, and play at The Connection, Mississippi's retail entertainment destination. Located at the intersection of I-20 and I-55 in Pearl.
When you're ready to make a move in Pirate Country, contact Penny Pitts with Havard Real Estate Group in Pearl. Penny is a multi-million dollar producer and loves to help her clients find the home of their dreams. If you are a first-time home buyer or ready to upsize or downsize, she is the agent for you. Penny is a Pearl High School graduate and an avid supporter of Pirate Athletics. Make your move with the home team. That's Penny Pitts, Havard Real Estate Group.
With the Pearl Pirate Football Coaches Show here at Mugshots Grill and Bar, I have sitting with me Coach Durr, defense linebackers coach. Let's talk about what we saw implemented as Pearl went to Ridgeland. A great win for them, by the way. Certainly, we saw that not only implemented on the offensive side, but the defensive side as well, too. What are some of your takeaways from the game?
Well, when you play a team like that with the double wing and everything they do, like, we had to really just overhaul the whole defense. We had to put in a different defense really and truly, and you got to line up people, and it's a very disciplined defense. You have to line them up and you tell them, hey, control what you're going to control and do what you're supposed to do. And linebackers, we're reading the guards because they're going to take it to the ball. And then the secondary's in man coverage, and they're sitting there watching. If they block, hey, we're coming down, we're playing football. If they go out for a pass, we got to run with them. So
come on.
It's completely, everybody has to stay at home and do what they're supposed to do. And when they do it right, everything turned out really well.
That's right, certainly. And I want to talk a little bit about Cam, how much of a leader he's been on that line as well, too. How has just his motivation and a leader, how has he been able to implement and help with that line?
Yeah, big Cam Hewitt.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's done really well this season. You know, like everybody, they usually run away from him.
Yeah.
And then, you know, one of our big leaders on defense also is Tyler Jenkins.
That's right.
You know, he's a vocal guy. He's the one I'll look at and go, hey, man, we got to get him going. No matter what happens, you know, good, bad, offense, turnovers, no matter what happens, we have to keep playing. And that's what we try to get him to do. And I'll look at him and go, hey, man, go get these guys going.
Yeah.
And he'll go over there and say, let's go. And that, you know, it's easy for us to always have to do the motivation, but it's a lot easier on us when we get somebody to go in there and do that for us.
Right.
So, you know, I can just look at him and go, hey, man, let's get him going. He goes, I got you.
Yeah.
And he runs over there and starts getting them going. And
yeah,
it usually turns out pretty good when they get going pretty good.
Absolutely. And that's such an impact, not only for the D-line, but for the whole team as well.
It is.
How are we seeing some of that being implemented, coming off a great win like we saw at Ridgeland, but also getting ready for Germantown this week?
Yeah, Germantown, it's a completely different type of offense. You know, last week was double wing, a lot of running, and now they're going to be empties. Then they're going to have tight ends. They're going to have, you know, the quarterback's a dynamic player. He can throw it and run
it. Right.
So, you know, we have to really, you know, we got to do different things this week. You know, every week, you know, is a different week. So what you did last week is not necessarily what we're going to do this week. And we just got to contain him and keep him under control and, you know, not let him get loose.
Yeah, absolutely. Which is y'all did a really great job of that at Ridgeland. And what was some of the motivation coming into Ridgeland? I know sometimes coming off a loss, two losses at that, the morale can come down, but saw that really pick up against Ridgeland. What were the coaches, what were y'all really implementing there to get ready for that game?
Well, you know, defensively, we have, you know, I always think it's our game. Like, we have to, if they don't score, we're never going to lose. So, like, you know, that's what we always go into the game thinking. And then, you know, like our kids, we're pretty good on the defensive ball when we get out there and start playing hard. So, you know, just preach to them, you know, you keep playing hard and everything's going to be fine.
Right.
You know, and that's what we just try to do every week, just constantly tell them, like, hey, we got to keep rolling.
Right.
You know, I started hollering during, not hollering, talking where everybody could hear me. You know, like, no matter what I kept telling them, you know, like when the offense, you know, would have a turnover, you know, or anything would happen. I said, it don't matter what happens. No matter what, we got to go out there and play.
Absolutely.
So turnovers, anything bad, you know, defense has got to go out there and play. So we got to take care of the offense. And then once they figure it out, you know, and they figured it out pretty well this week and scored some points and everything was rolling along pretty good.
As far as the coaches, anything that y'all really want to see come together for this Germantown game? Of course, I know y'all probably talk and after practice today and you're still trugging along forward. Anything that y'all really want to see that connects well?
Well, the defensive staffs, we're really tight-knit group. You know, we got some older guys, we got some younger guys, and we've worked together for quite a few years, and, you know, we've known each other for a while. So, you know, Coach Schooler coming in, you know, he just embraced us, and we've come together, and, like, it's like a family back in the defensive office, and we're all there for each other.
That's
you
right.
know, if one of us knows more than the other one, you know, they will ask, and then, you know, we'll go in there and tell them, and we'll work it out.
Yeah.
And, you know, just if we can just get everybody to play, you know, to do what they're supposed to do, you know, every play, you know, the defense will work really well.
Absolutely.
The whole season.
Well, I appreciate you, Coach. Again, Coach Durr here with us, defensive linebackers coach, doing the work. We saw that at Ridgeland versus Titans. Pearl versus Ridgeland, that is. As we get closer to this game coming up for Germantown, I know the Pirates will be able to do that as well, too, implementing not only a great defense but also a great offense. Stay tuned. More to come here with the Pearl Pirate Football Coaches Show at Mugshots Grill and Bar.
When Pirates need a feast, they sail to Mugshots Grill and Bar. Voted best burger in Mississippi for 13 years in a row, Mugshots proudly serves fresh, never-frozen certified Angus beef. X marks a spot at two locations on the map, in Pearl and Riverwind Drive in the movie theater parking lot, and in Flowood on the corner of Airport Road and Lakeland Drive. You can dine in, take out, or order online and pick up curbside. Check out mugshotsgrillandbar.com.
When accidents happen, our 30 minutes or less ER service pledge can mean less waiting and faster care. The 30 minutes or less ER service pledge at Merit Health.
Auto, home, renters, business, watercraft, personal umbrella, and church insurance, even annuities. When we list it all out, we're proud to show just how diversified our products have become since Alpha Insurance was founded in 1946. Chances are we've got a policy just for you from knowledgeable hometown agents like Justin D. Null. Call Justin today at 601-487-6714 or visit our office at 3823 Highway 80 East, Suite 500 in Pearl for more information.
Well, we're back here at the Pearl Pirate Football Coaches Show with Coach Patrick Schooler. Wrapping things up with me, let's talk a little bit about the gameplay as we get ready to go into Germantown. I know we hit on it, but just some extra remarks for the fans, families, and friends that'll be tuned in. What are your thoughts so far as you, of course, got practice this week and we get closer to it?
It's going to be a big game. We're going to play really well to win. They're a 7A program. They're North Mississippi, of course, but it's going to be a dogfight. Usually is with those guys. They're well coached, and they got a dynamic playmaker at quarterback and who makes things tough on defensive-minded people. So, at the end of the day, we're going to play really well if we want to win.
And, you know, we've seen a bit of a trend here, and I actually was listening to a podcast not too long ago. Quarterbacks, they're not pocket quarterbacks a whole lot anymore like
no,
they used
they're
to
not.
Be. There, a lot of them are beating the line with their legs. And so we saw this not only at Warren Central, Ridgeland had this as well, too, and now we're going into Germantown. And I know y'all have been – not only the defense, but y'all been really boosting that and getting ready for that.
Oh, yeah. Well, we've seen a dual threat quarterback since Brookhaven. And so if we can contain him like we can contain the kid from Brookhaven, we'll have a chance to win the ball game. The difference between him and the kid from Brookhaven was this kid can throw it a mile. So you're never safe in the back end at all. You got to cover until the whistle blows or the ball's on the ground, one or the other, because he can flip it 45, 50 yards just by just flipping his wrist. So. They're big up front. They get after it. They run the ball pretty well, but they can throw it down the field with anybody in the state, probably.
Yeah.
So we're going to be really good in the back end. And we've been pretty good in the back end, knock on wood on that. But so if we can get a little pressure on the quarterback, And if we can get some big stops in the secondary, we'll have a chance to win the ball game. If we don't defend it deep, it's going to be a long night for us. So defensively, that they are who they are. They're the same team that's going to play every Friday night. So right. they're going to get us a 5-2 man zero box a lot. And we got to be able to block them.
Right.
And if you can't block them, we'll have a problem. If we can block them, get creases, then we'll be getting second level, third level pretty quick because there's no way back there.
Right.
But the problem is getting them all blocked.
Right.
Because a lot of times they'll bring more than you can block. They'll try to overload a side, bring more pressure off one end than you can. So, but again, I think Coach Anderson and that staff's got a good game plan against them.
Right.
But then it goes back to those 15, 16-year-old, 17-year-old boys that, that we all depend on for a job, right? So, if they'll execute it, I think we'll have a chance to be in the ball game in the fourth quarter. That's all we ask for them. Let's get to the fourth quarter.
Right.
You know, keep us in the ball game in the fourth quarter, and then we'll figure out how to win one.
Yeah.
So if we're not, then it's going to be a long night.
That's right.
But like I said, I think we have a good chance to. Like it's going to take all three phases.
Right.
We've got to kick some field goals, probably. You know, right. Colson had hit a big one last Friday night. To the non-football person, don't understand how big it was. I think it's like a 34-yarder, maybe a little longer, but it made it a two-score game.
Right.
You know, they couldn't catch us last week and we kicked the field goal, so which was also huge because we had two bad snaps on PATs and so we. I had a lot of faith in Owen and Colson there, and Wynn get it all down. It happened. So, good coaching call because it worked, right?
Absolutely.
If it wouldn't have worked, it'd been a bad coaching call. So, but Germantown's going to be well coached. It's going to be a big game, homecoming, right? So you got to deal with a little homecoming problems. But you know, most of the time kids are okay with that now. They had a big parade on Thursday night. Kids, they'll enjoy that. The parade, they'll come back into the stadium for the homecoming. The citywide pet rally,
right,
and then have a couple of pet rallies on Friday morning at school. You know, the other day it's all about kids.
Yeah,
you know, do we want to win football games? All that stuff. Yes, we do. But it's gonna be a fun weekend for the kids. Right. Hopefully, we can separate from good time to a Friday night game.
Absolutely.
You know, separate for just 3 hours there and go be great.
Right. Absolutely. I was gonna ask you. You know, what are y'all doing as coaches? Of course, homecoming coming up. Got that on Thursday. But, you know, also keeping the mindset, hey, guys, go have fun.
Yeah.
But we have that game coming up on Friday. Let's make sure we're not only having fun, but locking in when we get back from practice on Friday.
It's got to treat it like every week. Right. I know that's coach talk, but it's treat like every week. You know, when we get them over there, we don't think about pep rallies or homecoming itself. We think about going to win football games.
Right.
So.
Absolutely. Well, let's segue a little bit here. We have some of the highlights from Germantown. This is their game last Friday. Getting into what we've been seeing so far from them, and I know y'all have been watching far as a film play for them to get ready for this game as well.
Deep ball. He can throw it. He can throw a deep ball with the best of them. So he's also pretty elusive. He's a bigger kid that can throw it, but he also, if he don't like what he sees, he'll run it. You know, so we've got to do a really good job of boxing him in and staying over top. You know, if they check down, throw it underneath. You know, make the catch, make a throw. Number 13 and 7 are really explosive players, 4 and 5 and 8, and that they got a pass of them over they can go. So really good timing on the hitches there, and he takes that 6-yard pass for 35, 40 yards. So that's tough. You got to be able to defend these guys. And come up, make a tackle like that. Make that tackle, it's a 7-8-yard gain, play the next down. But if you miss a tackle, it goes to 40-yard gains, and that's a big momentum swing. And football is such a game of momentum that we've got to keep it on our side. So, see, he's a step in that pocket and comes out the back door over there, and he's not a scared runner. He'll lower his head and go physical on you real quick. But if we can get to him and hit him a few times, maybe we can get him off his mark a little bit and, you know, play good pirate football.
Yeah, that's right. Certainly, try to get in there and mix things up a little bit for them.
Yeah.
That'll potentially – try to slow that drive down for the Germantown.
Yep.
So, absolutely. Anything or extra remarks you want to leave everybody with as we get closer to it?
Keep believing, keep coming.
That's right.
I think I tell the kids all the time, if we do what we're supposed to do and continue improving, we're going to like we are in November.
Right.
You know, we're looking for November, right?
Right.
You know? So if we get November and we like where we are, then we succeeded as a team. So we'll see where we're at.
Well, Coach, I appreciate you for everything that you've been doing for us, especially for the Pearl Pirate family as well. Looking forward to seeing great things at Germantown in the games to come. Also, I want to thank the fans for tuning in as well, too. This is the Pearl Pirate Football Coaches Show, which happens and brought to you by Mugshots Grill and Bar. We do this on Mondays. It starts at 6, so certainly you can come and attend this and not only meet Coach himself, but meet some of the players that come and hang out to be a part of this broadcast. Stay tuned
Of course, big game coming up as Pearl Pirates take on Germantown.
Thank you for watching PMB Sports. The preceding broadcast is copyrighted by Pearl Municipal Broadcasting for the private use of our audience. Any other use of this broadcast without the written consent of Pearl High School or PMB is prohibited.